many of you who know Gurudev, they also know how personal touch, you know, everybody can have a personal relation with him, and he knows what you want, right thing, you know. So I'll tell you an instance. Once it so happened that one of the boys in our ashram, we have Vishalakshmi Mantap, there satsang happened every day. So in one of the satsang, a lot of Gujaratis had come. They had brought a lot of sweets. So they had given it to Gurudev, offering, no? So it was all kept, and then later one boy will collect everything and bring it to Gurudev's Ganga Kutir. So then one boy who was there managing, one Pandu his name was, and he wanted a particular sweet. He loved that sweet, and he was eyeing the sweet all the time. He told me later, you know. But other person has collected everything and taken it in the basket to Ganga without, you know. So then he said, oh, I wanted it like that. He had the wish. After 2 days exactly, this box goes to him from another sevak from the Ganga. Upkarji went, took it to Pandu, and he's saying, Gurudev sent you this box. So he told me later, Didi, how did Gurudev know that I wanted this? Do din ke pehle main to isko hi dekh raha tha, I wanted to take it. So like that, he knows, you know, everything. He knows who wants what to the dot. So this really amazes me. You can't ask me how he knows. I'm also wondering about it.
Interesting question. He meets so many people, he travels so many places. Yeah. How does he select whom to meet, where to travel?
This is very interesting, because it's like wherever there is a pull, wherever there is a need, he goes, you know. Gurudev always has spoken about this in a comb of knowledge. He says, if one strand is pulled, then you know that this strand is there. They're like that, wherever there is a need. The masters, enlightened master, come there. So I tell you another instance. I don't know whether I've written it in here. This. So there was a satsang in Bombay, Mumbai. Huh? So Mumbai, you know how big satsangs, and so many people, and Chitra knows about it, you know, even in olden days, right? So many, so much crowd, and there were two ladies. Women who had come from Ahmedabad, and then they wanted to come near him and touch his feet, take his ashirwad. They couldn't come because there was too much of a crowd. So they were feeling bad about it, but still, you know, they just, at least, chalo, we were in the satsang, they felt like that. And then they went into the train. So incidentally, Gurudev also travelled in the same train, and they had arranged a train journey. And these women were in the ladies' compartment. So Gurudev, in this train, it was express, you know, but they were made to stop in every other station. There people were meeting him like that happened. So one such stop, the train started moving, because there were so many people, you know, garrowing him. What is that?
Crowding him.
Crowding him. So Gurudev just ran and went into some compartment that happened to be the ladies' compartment. And there, these two ladies were there. They've gone and dashed to his feet. They were the happiest.
Absolutely.
I tell you, they said, Gurudev, you have only come for us to this. Otherwise, there is no reason for him to travel in that. So they were so happy like this, you know. There is, everybody has a line, a direct line for him. I think connection is there.
So true. All of our experience.